I was in Spa and I got these. They were £1.49 each. I know it's quite dear, but they're American imports. I could tell just by looking at the typeface and the way the nutrition information's listed. It seems to always be the same. And I knew that with them being American, they've got high fructose corn syrup in rather than real sugar. It's one of my bugbears about America. They've got all the best weather they could have, all the best ingredients for the food and drink, but they don't, because the cynical food and drink companies just get incentives to use high fructose corn syrup. And of course, high fructose corn syrup makes you, it's got this weird effect that it makes you want even more of it. It's got this weird aftertaste that makes you almost thirsty again, so you want more and more and more and more and more of it. It's weird. Whereas Coke UK uses real sugar, as in fact most of them do now. Although, because of that stupid sugar tax. Thanks, Jamie Oliver. I'll just censor my own rude gesture with a finger there. Means that now we have a load of stupid artificial sweeteners mixed in with it, which has ruined the flavour of many drinks. I'm hoping that'll get reversed. The two flavours that I got strawberry, and this one's just berry, and it's got blueberries and raspberry flavour sort of thing, looking by the picture. So there's a picture at the end so you can see what's in it and what's not in it. It's a shame I didn't get a third flavour, because then I could have had Fanta A, Fanta B, Fanta C. Terrible joke. And this is the strawberry one. Oh, and the bit of the splash onto the can there has made it look very red indeed. I've always wanted to know, because each country's got varying degrees of what's allowed in food and drink. This one's got sodium benzoate in it as a preservative. To protect the taste, it's got in brackets. And red 40 is the colour they've used. Now, another E120 is cochineal, which is ground up bugs. Which is nice. It's an old Victorian sort of thing. That is astonishingly red. I've never seen anything quite this red. I wonder if it's legal in the UK. It looks a bit like Fanta, but it looks a bit like Fanta. It looks a bit more like Tarza, just a bit redder, because Tarza is a bit red, orangey, isn't it? It smells very, very fake strawberry-like. Now, strawberry drinks, Rabina strawberry is nice, but generally, strawberry drinks are generally quite rubbish. I can tell it's high fructose corn syrup. Because I don't feel refreshed or anything, and here comes the dry aftertaste. Oh God, Americans are just so let down by their food and drink companies. They really are. This is not refreshing. It is for about 5 seconds. And then instantly, I just want to drink more and more and more of this now. It's weird. Oh. It tastes artificially strawberry-like. And it tastes quite similar to a kind of sweet that I've had. Oh, this aftertaste is flipping awful. It feels like I'm so thirsty again now. I can feel that some liquid has gone down, but oh, it's awful stuff. High fructose corn syrup, and it's the second degree. Does it actually have any real sugar in it? Carbonated water, high fructose corn syrup, natural flavours, with the letter U missing, of course. Citric acid, sodium benzoate to protect taste. Flipping heck if that one in there, I don't think it tastes anything. And red 40. I wonder if it is cochineal. I'm going to have to look it up. I'll probably put it in the caption if I can find out what it is. It's so weird, because high fructose corn syrup doesn't coat your tongue. You can feel it at the back, just sort of under your nose, you know, right at the back of your mouth. And you can feel it going down. And you get it almost on this side, on the side of your tongue here, but only. And then it's gone. So I've nearly consumed that entire can, but I don't feel any refreshment at all. I feel thirsty. probably more thirsty than I actually was. Because to start this video, what I actually had was, I had a couple of boxes of fries to go, which is these chips that you put in the microwave. French fries, I suppose I should say, since it's quite American themed. And they make you incredibly thirsty because they're so dry and crispy. And what else did I have to make myself that? And something else to go with it to make me thirsty. Let's try this berry flavour now. Except there's no saliva left on my tongue. Let's try the berry one now. What's it? Ooh! It smells like them blue raspberry sort of Mr. Freeze pop things that you get in the UK. Carbonated water, I thought just corn syrup. Natural flavour, citric acid, sodium citrate this time, malic acid, potassium sorbate and sodium benzoate, and blue one. I'm going to have to look these up because we use E-numbers in the UK to things. Not all E-numbers are bad, by the way. Sometimes we'll use it just to save space on packaging and whatnot, and because it's a slight variant of something. So if they've added something to salt to make it last longer, pardon me for belching. They might do something like an E number for it because it'd be too long to put the whole name of what they've created. And that is very blue. I don't know if it's coming across on camera because it's hard to tell on LCD screens, isn't it, what blue is. It is very blue. It's almost like some sort of Paradise Islands sea sort of blue. It smells very blue raspberry sort of smell. And this one I can't even taste. All I can taste is I cooked as corn syrup. I knew they weren't going to be great. I hope they bring these flavours to the UK so I can put some real sugar in them. I bet they'll taste amazing. They're at rest on my tongue now. It really tastes to nothing. All I can taste is gloop. Maybe they didn't put quite enough sodium benzoate in to protect the flavours. That really tastes and smells quite different from each other. Maybe it's better out the can. No, that one's not impressive at all. They are in date, aren't they? Yeah, they're in date. December 2019. Although it'd be out of date now if you're watching this way into the future. Nah. Don't like that. 100% natural flavours? Where? Well, 12 flosses is 355 ml.
Oh, right.
So it's slightly a bit more than the... It's not a standard, I don't think, but quite often in the UK, the cans are 330 ml. I don't know why. It just seems to be a thing. I don't know why I've not investigated any of that yet. Maybe I should. And American, I have noticed, it always seems to be about 355 ml. It's strange, or 350 ml. What is it, 355? Yeah. Yeah, a UK Coke tastes much better than an American Coke. And I think the same goes with Fanta. I should have got the orange one and done a taste comparison, but it's hard to do now because the stupid sugar tax thing that stupid Jamie Oliver brought in. Oh, God, what a geek he is. And I'm very sure that America definitely knows who Jamie Oliver is. Anyway, oh, I should mix them together, shouldn't I? So let's mix the strawberry with the berry. What's the berry? Strawberry. What sort of colour has it gone? It's gone a weird brown sort of colour. It's gone like a cola colour. That is weird. Can you imagine if this tasted exactly the same as cola, the secret ingredients? Of course it tasted of the strawberry one, doesn't it? Because the blueberry one tasted of nothing. Well, I think we should go for a hidden review. Ta-da! I don't think I've tried a Fifth Avenue before. There's the thing so you can see what's good and what's bad. And the ingredients. See, I want an ice cream now. Ta-da! Got an ice cream from the ice cream van instead. Mmm. Lovely. That can wait for another time. Mmm. Just messy eater. And it's got the flake in there as well, look, because it's a proper nanny nan. Mmm. Although, I don't think I just do double cone ones. I miss the double coned ice cream. Come on. Thanks for watching. Scrass, don't forget to bell me. Bye!